Breakaway. Breakaway. Video Magazine. Part 3.
Incredible. Breakaway Video Mag, chilling out here in Oklahoma City with my man Brian Free Joe.
What's up,
brother?
Culture Shock.
Culture Party. Shock.
Seminole Nation, my homeboy DJ Will.
What's up?
That was a fat event last night, man. What made you put that event together?
Thanks, man. Just trying to show hip hop's everywhere, man. Hip hop right here in the middle of the United States, man. Indian country. Mm-hmm. Represent natives, represent all four colors, four directions. Trying to show we can do something positive. Show these kids, show the youth, you know, the future. We're gonna do something positive and represent on that level.
Right.
So it turned out real nice. Everybody showed up.
Mm-hmm.
Rip One, Ivan, and Mr. Wiggles.
Yeah, it was all that. What are we heading to right now?
Right now we're going to an event. It's called Red Earth. It's a big celebration we have here every year, every summer. All the top dancers in the world, Native American dancers, we represent here today. You're gonna see the fancy dance, old school fancy dance. It's a traditional dance.
Original Top Rock.
Original. Yeah, Oklahoma, Indian country.
No doubt.
Today.
Brian Free Joe. So what was the purpose of the event last night? I know that event was basically for a reason that you created. You know, what was that all about?
Man, it's called Culture Shock. Trying to showcase, trying to highlight Native Americans, Native people trying to come up in the hip-hop industry, expressing themselves, you know, on the four elements, breaking, MCing, DJing, graffiti art. I want to see our people come up, you know, kind of been overlooked for a long time, a lot of things, unless it's culture. Yeah, culture, you know, we adapt. Let's say the year 2000, we adapted. We're as much a part of hip-hop as anybody else. And that's the vision behind the event, to show that we're out there doing stuff too. Whatever tribal, cultural background you come from, and that's what we're showing right here last night. We got people there witnessed it. We got it on video. You know, ain't no denying it. We're here. We're coming up. We hope in the future it even gets bigger.
All right, Mr. Wiggles chilling out here with the brother Poncho. I'm sorry, your last name?
Grady.
Grady. Oh man, I don't know where to begin, man. I feel like there's a lot that needs to be said on hip hop dance and its origins. And, you know, me and a lot of the members of like Rocksteady Crew were big fans of the Fancy Dance. We got footage of it one time hanging out at PBS station.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
They have a big library. And we saw it, and the minute we saw it, we said, man, these brothers is top rocking.
Yeah.
They're top rocking, and yo, wow. What is the origin of this dance?
The origin was, it started down in the southern tribes in Oklahoma, like the Punkas, and mainly the southern tribe, that's where it originated. And it was to, at first it started out as, fancy dance was trying to, was the imitator of a horse, like a quarter horse.
Hmm.
You know how horses, you know how they act up?
They,
you know,
gallop.
They dally up. And like in horse racing, like when they race and they got them things on the side.
Right.
And they got their steps that go, you know, back and forth. And when you come out of them, you know, shoot things. That's what, you know, fancy dancers trying to imitate that. And when they do that, like different kicks and stuff, they try to do that. But then again, they try to stick to more. I mean, like way back when it first started, it was really acrobatic. You know, guys would come off cartwheeling before the contest about two or three times. And some guys, you know, would just get real creative, like do splits.
Yeah,
all
yeah.
All around splits, dance all around splits. Then as time went along, you know, it got more and more, you know, acrobatic.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel representing Native people in hip-hop?
I guess it's, you know, to me, it really doesn't matter, you know, what race you are, you know. I guess hip-hop's for everybody, but represent, since there's not a lot of Native B-boys, you know, I mean, a lot of people don't know that I'm Native. Not that I'm Native, you know, I don't look it, but hey, I'm inside, you know, I'm not trying to prove to anybody anything, but, you know, it's a pleasure for me to go out and represent these people, you know, from Arizona.
And you break, and where do you practice?
At, practice at Rollo Baptisto Teen Center in Salt River, Arizona.
Mm-hmm. Is it on a reservation?
Yeah, it's in the reservation, Salt River, just outside of Phoenix.
What do your people think about it when they see you?
A lot of elders say, you know, why are you doing this? You know, this isn't our culture, you know? Mm-hmm. And I say, I go, that's when it comes to a part of hip hop. That's what comes in that side where you say,
right,
it's not about, you know, who you are in hip hop. It's for anybody. You know, like they always say, it's for any race. And, you know, and for my culture's inside me. That's something I can't forget, you know, you can't take it away. It's in my blood, it's already running in me, you know?
Yeah. Culture Shock 2. For all the native people, remember, your contributions to hip hop is definite. Check it out, original Top Rock. Love and respect to all the people and queens of native descent that represent it. Down the rock too, Everlast too, and all the rest of y'all. Love and respect, y'all incredible. Check it out. To Linda, MC Quest, and MC One, the help of the people of it together, y'all. Peace. To all the ancestral warriors for keeping the spirit alive. Peace. I hope. Yeah. For more information, contact Brian Frejo, 405-557-2578. Peace. Yeah, out of Miami, coming to you live. B-Boy Teal, Steve.
Here in Los Angeles for Wiggles Breakaway Volume 3. We're chilling out here with Teal Steele, a man of many hats, and we're about to link up with him and see what kind of gems he has to drop, what's up in his dome piece. What up, Teal?
What up?
How do you like it out here in Los Angeles? I know you're kind of new to the mix over here. What do you think about all this sunshine and b-boying out here?
It's cool. I like it. It's fat. It's like a lot of different cats, a lot of different styles, a lot of different power moves, you know. It's cool. It's dope.
Yeah? Some of the best air moves you've seen, or what do you think?
Yeah, there's a lot of good cats out here. A lot of good styles too, like all over Cali, you know.
Right on. So let's see, man. You've made your way across the country from a couple different places. You just recently, what? You came here from New York?
Yeah, I came up here from up in the east, up north, from Jersey, New York. You know, yeah, I was kicking it out there with different cats and shit, doing my thing out there, you know.
Word up. What when you were in New York, what influenced you out there, like your current style? I know you linked up with a couple brothers out there that kind of schooled you on the classic Brooklyn rock style. You want to drop any knowledge about that?
Well, I linked up with I was like hanging with Crazy Legs and Rock Study, and I met these brothers from Incredible Breakers, Chino, Brian, and Sammy, and the little protege, actually Josh is Incredible Breaker too. He's really incredible. But he's dope, man. And you know, them cats, Sammy and Chino and them, they're incredible b-boys. And up, and Sam is like a crazy up rocker from back in the day, you know. And I picked up a lot of ill shit from them, you know, original styles and stuff.
That's dope, man. So what's up, man? You came from Miami, right, originally?
Miami, Florida, yeah.
Right? That's where you started b-boying, or what?
Yep, that was my foundation right there. Learning from different cats out there, you know, street masters, and, you know, and just different cats out there, you know, just doing my thing out there. That was my beginning right there. And, you know, I represent Miami to the fullest now, and, you know, that's where I'm from, yeah.
Dope. Miami, if anybody's ever traveled out there, I know that, you know, the b-boying scene out there is, it's not massive, but what it lacks in numbers, it makes up in character. I mean, I went out there for the Blaze b-boy battle, I don't know, maybe a year ago or something, and I was amazed at these cats' overall style and flavor of even dress and just the way they rolled and stuff. I was like, damn, I don't think I had seen any b-boys that were that raw in the U.S. on my travels anyway. What do you think about that? I mean, what, you know, is it something out there? Is it the water? Is it like, I mean, what is it?
No, well, check it. It's like, to me, I always like original styles, you know, like even from where I began, I got inspired by Little Lep and Ken Swift watching Beat Street, you know, and that's my personal opinion. You know, a lot of people, you know, just got inspired by other, you know, other things. I can't really speak on them, but a lot has to do with like the B-Boy Masters program that Zulu Gremlin and Speed Legs throw every year. You know, that's very big, you know, how do you say that? Very big
inspiration,
influence out there. And because a lot of people come through town, and, you know, a lot of kids just, you know, pick up things and battle and just, you know, have fun, man, you know. Especially when Storm came out and Kenny and everybody else, man. It was like, wow, when I first seen Storm, he inspired me too. And I was like, wow, this shit is real, you know.
True indeed. So on the writing tip, I know you write graffiti. And what crew are you down with, or crew should I say?
I'm down with FC, Fame City, First Class. You know, my man Dash put me onto that. He put me onto West, and I hooked up with FC. And I'm down with IBM and GM5, which are Devious Dozers. You know, he put me down. That those are like his cliques, you know, like GM5 stands for Grandmasters 5. It's like a little thing off the original TC5. And IBM stands for Incredible Bombing Masters. And those are my cliques, man. That's what I push when I go out there and do my graph.
Dope, yo. Yeah, your graph is dope. I know a lot of people out here too that, you know, you've done a couple pieces out here and people are like, yo, he's got a really dope style. He's got that, you know, original lettering style and stuff. It's just dope. So what's up? Any last words of wisdom or shout outs or speak your mind?
I want to give a shout out to all my peoples around, man. In Miami, my brother Kazai Rock, to all my boys out there, to Skill Methods, to the Boogie Brats, KML, and then all my peeps out here in LA and Cali. I want to say what's up to G-Wiz, to Stunts, to Ho, to Stylums, to Remind and Crumbs. I want to say what's up to Flo and everybody else, you know. And I just want to, like, you know, say to all the B-Boys out there, just, you know, learn from, you know, from the foundation, man. Just, you know, like, try to, like, pick up the originality of the dance.
Right.
You know, be keep it real, you know.
Keep it moving, right?
Right.
Definitely. All right, well, that's Teal Steele. And you might see him at a city near you doing his thing, wrecking it in the circles and the ciphers. This is Asia One for Mr. Wiggles Breakaway Volume 3. We out.
Yeah. Give it up for Teal Steele. Check it out. Out here in Holland, chilling with these brothers from Hungary.
Yeah.
What's the name of the crew?
Yeah, Suicide Life and Elemental Force.
Suicide. So y'all two groups from Hungary that joined together for the battle.
Yeah.
So you were the guys that made it to the ending.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a good battle. That was a good battle.
Good,
it was even. It was a close one.
It was too short.
I was just telling you guys that I think that battling on stage is more like a performance. A real battle is in the crowd, you know, in the circles.
Yeah.
Natural. It's more like a contest, you know?
Yeah.
You can't pick a winner.
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's much better.
Huh?
You got more feeling.
In the crowd, right?
Yes. More feeling.
So how long you guys been breaking?
I'm dancing 7 years with Ice. We started with Ice, and the other people dancing 5 years and 6 years.
Yeah? And who's the old school group from Hungary?
Enemy Squad.
Yeah.
Squad.
Enemy Squad. I didn't know they were from Hungary. They're bad.
Yeah,
Enemy Squad is the shit.
They are teaching me. I'm teaching them.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
So they're like the guys that you guys look up to, Enemy Squad in Hungary?
What?
Enemy Squad is the main old school group that you all look up to.
The only one.
Every country has their old school group, you know what I mean? Peace.
Hello.
Hello. He's the last guy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, pay your bill, man. So yeah, did y'all have a good time out here though?
Yeah.
So what's the problems in Hungary with hip hop?
Nobody understands Hungarian hip hop. Nobody knows what is the hip hop. That's why nobody like it. I'm telling everybody, hip hop is four elements and blah blah blah. Oh yeah. I don't care. I don't give a fuck.
You know what I hate? It's always the B-boys that recognize hip-hop, never the rappers, you know what I mean? And the graffiti writers, B-boys and the graffiti writers, that recognize real hip-hop.
Yeah, it's too young to be the same.
Yeah? Well...
Try to improve my whole more hip-hop. Because we have my whole brother, Rookie, rapping, and the other Rookie, he's making graffiti.
Yeah. And you're teaching them?
Yes. It's
plenty young. So soon y'all gonna be the old school, then you gotta pass it on. That's good. Boy, I understand. I hate when people call me old school. I say original school. Who's your influences? One at a time. Say names, man.
My name is Sam.
Okay. The Apple guy. Who's your influence? B-boy.
Miquela.
Who? Who's your influence? Your favorite B-boy in the world. Nobody? All right, let's die. That many?
Maybe. England guy.
Evo?
Evo.
I like Evo. Evo's
like,
bad.
Bad.
Yeah, I really like Evo. Your name?
Sorry.
What's your name, bro?
Sorry.
Who's your favorite B-boy in the world?
My favorite is Ivan.
Ivan?
No.
Yeah.
He's
a nut. There's something wrong with Ivan.
Crazy.
Actually, he's my boy. He's incredible.
Hi, my name is Nova. And I don't have favorite dancer.
That's cool.
I don't like only one, man.
You like many?
Yeah.
Me too. Yeah? Many B-boys?
Yeah. My brothers.
Ivan?
I like many B-boys.
You don't like them, you just like the way they dance. Nah, I'm just kidding. What's yours?
Hey, I'm Ovish, and I like other people.
Yeah, my name is Ice. A big shout out to the Rocks of the Crew.
Hello.
I like the Rocks of the Crew very well, but I have to tell a big shout out to Quickstep and Kema.
Okay.
They're teaching us in New York 2 years now.
Oh, man.
Shout out to
K-Mel
and Quickstep,
Full Circle. Those are my boys. K-Mel is a young, up-and-coming B-boy.
I love K-Mel.
Yeah, he doesn't care.
The lingual is in K-Mel house, and Elijah.
Huh?
The lingual is in K-Mel house.
Oh.
We go there and K-Mel said, oh, come on, sit my place.
Yeah, he's a good kid.
Yeah.
Good, and I like his attitude.
Yeah, I like
he's
him.
He was in the Bronx 2 years now, and we all the white people.
Y'all were in the Bronx? What part of the Bronx?
170. We live in the 170.
Oh, Grand Concourse?
2 years.
Y'all are crazy.
Me and Gombe, yeah.
Yeah?
We don't care.
That's
and
real.
Sometimes, someday, I'm just walking in a street, and the Bronx guy, oh, you street dancer, you're dancing in zone. Yeah. Oh, let me see your head spin. And I'm just take it off. The little yellow, you know, I'm in the street, and I do head spin. Good.
After a while, you guys just start to blend in, don't you, in the Bronx?
What?
After a while, you just blend in, right?
I don't know what it's blending.
Blending means you mix in with the people in the Bronx. Yeah, if people wanted to get in contact with you, how could they get in contact with you?
I don't know, we have a phone call, we take a call, in New York or here?
All over.
We always traveling in the world. We are street dancing.
Oh, yeah?
Street dancing all over the world, making money like this.
Yeah. But how can they find you?
On the streets.
Yeah. Yeah. Next up, Grand Wizard. Theodore.
Thank you.
one of my heroes, Grand Wizard Theodore. And it was like my pleasure watching this brother cut. One thing I gotta ask you, man, it's like, you know, I like the DJs today.
One second, yo.
I like the DJs today, man, but the one thing that's missing from the DJs is the funk. And, you know, what I miss is that I can't dance to when DJ's doing the tricks.
Right.
When you cutting, you can get down. You know what I'm saying? Because you always keep, it's like a metronome.
Yeah,
everything's
yeah.
on beat. What's up with that?
You know? It comes to 25 years of DJing. Like, I'm used to playing for people that's dancing. People dance with their girl, you know? So that stays with me throughout my whole life. I want to make sure that everybody comes to my parties and everybody is dancing. I don't want nobody to miss the beat. People pay their money to get inside the party. They come in with their girl and they dancing. So that's going to stay with me for the rest of my life.
That's the heart of DJing.
That's it. Yep.
I mean, I go to the DMCs and I appreciate the tricks. But even when y'all do tricks, it's always on beat.
Yeah.
Always.
Yeah.
And no matter how many cuts you do, how many blends you do, everything is like a metronome. And, you know, it's just something that's missing in the DJ world. Just like now, breakers don't dance as much no more.
Right.
Back in the days, B-boys used to dance more. Now they're into the same thing with the DJ world. So it's like a pleasure catching you out there doing your thing. Just give a shout out to all the dancers that see my shit.
Yeah, definitely. Yo, Wiggles is definitely keeping it real. He's definitely one of my idols. Every time I see him dance, it's like seeing him dance for the first time. A lot of you people out there should understand. You have to understand where the culture came from in order to know where the culture is going. So make sure you learn your history, you know what I'm saying? Always keep it real. No matter what you do, always keep it real. Peace.
Grand Wizard Theodore, my brother.
From the sketches commercial. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Check those crazy breakdances in the newest sketchy spot. They got it going on. We got the top B-boy, that's Breakers, from the East and West Coast, to spin, lock, and pop in Skechers sport footwear. Skechers is always stepping to the edge. Why don't you check us out hard at play, work.
Don't stop. That's a little close, my boy.
What's up, y'all? Mr. Wiggles chilling out here. Breakaway Video Mag with, of course, the infamous, famous
B-Boy Flow Master up in the Trinidad House.
We out here in Holland. We just did some rehearsals for a big industrial out here. It's kind of cool. B-Boys is even getting recognized by major industries, Volkswagen. But they had me and Flo come out here to do some work and Wicked. And my man Manny is going to finish it off for us in Austria for the Volkswagen industrial show where they're using B-Boys and Boogaloo to help represent and present the latest cars for the year 1989. So that's butter, man.
For sure.
But right now I'm with this brother because I want to talk about something with him. It's a new concept. New crew, the new clique that's coming out, created by Flow Master. Also, I helped him out with the name.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The group is called
Footwork Fanatics.
Footwork Fanatics.
Oh, yeah.
So what's the deal on this, huh?
Well, what it is the reason why we came up with Footwork Fanatics because a lot of breakers today doesn't do a lot of footwork. And the original style of breaking was footwork.
Mm-hmm.
And what I try to do with my crew is to get everybody who I recruit or put in, well, it's only two of us down with me and my boy Wicked and Freeze, is I make sure we have a lot of footwork. And not only that, we dance on the beat and stuff. So that's the main thing that I try to get my crew to remember, is a lot of footwork and dancing on the beat.
What do you think about the B-Boys that think they're doing footwork sometimes, but they're doing a lot of tricks? Isn't it like power movers? Not power movers, but like you get groups out there, they're doing a lot of intricate tricks, and they think they're doing text.
I see a lot of breakers today think they're doing footwork and text and all that, and it's not, you know, it really ain't. It's really not. If you really want to know what footwork is in 1998, now it's ready to be 1999, you gotta look at Prince Ken Swift now. His oh my goodness, his footwork is getting up there. My man Wicked, who didn't have a lot of good footwork now, that a lot of people out here think Wicked, you know, Wicked's doing footwork. No, man, I don't believe it. Yes, believe it. Wicked is getting nasty.
Anybody out there that is interested in getting in Footwork Fanatics, that think their footwork is good enough, now you gotta have your six step and your four step. That's Flo's major rule. It's not the only footwork that was existed in the old school, but that's his criteria for being a Footwork Fanatic. Six step, and you can study six steps by watching Kenny and Flo. Four step, look at B Street, look at Kenny. Those are very important, but if you feel your footwork is there, send footage to my P.O. box, all right? And I'm gonna get it to Flo. And Flo is going to look over all the footage. And any last words you want to say to people?
Just keep it real, man. Just keep on doing what, you know, what y'all doing.
Yeah. Footwork Fanatics for the year 2G. Right about now, taking the back to France. Check it out. Come on.
What's up, y'all? Peace, Mr. Wiggles. Breakaway Magazine. Chilling with my brother Amit from Paris, France. How you doing? So, how did you start, man? What made you start breaking?
I started in 1984 after I saw the first world hip hop company tour. It was New York City Rap with Ramon Z, Ron Hixa, DST, Afrika Bambaataa, and the Rock Steady Crew. After this, we started with my two brothers. We started with the Breaking Boys crew in the east of France, Metz. And I still continue dance today.
So, well, that tour he's talking about is a very historical tour. I believe it's one of the first tours to come to Europe. And you saw it.
Mm-hmm.
So who were your inspirations back then for breaking?
In France?
Let's say out the world first.
Frosty Freeze from Rock City Crew. Take One from Rock City Crew. And Crazy Legs. And Prince Can Sweat.
Ah, come on now. Everybody's hero.
It's my brother.
Yeah, and how about in here in France?
Here in France, I got my brother Philippe Letec, old school b-boy, very, very underground, very dope style, and old school style. He's the guy who inspired me.
Who were some of the earlier b-boys that were pioneers of French breaking?
French breaking? There is Nabil from Quintessence, Gabin from Actual Force, Philippe Letec, there is Xavier, there is Pascal, Noel.
Right, his brother's over there giving him, he's saying names, he's like,
Nicolas from Paris City Breakers, who were dancing with Sydney. TV show, hip-hop.
Famous hip-hop TV show here in France back in the early 80s.
Yeah. He inspired me too, Nicolas from PCB. He's my brother too.
Qu'en France, comme dans beaucoup de pays,
like many countries,
il y a trop un manque d'originalité.
People miss their originality.
C'est pas une attaque.
It's not an attack, but.
Mais il faut danser avant tout avec son cœur.
But you have to dance with a heart.
Et ça va respecter ceux qui ont ramené et qui ont innové cette danse.
And respect those that brought the dance in France and all the countries.
Et pas chercher à chaque fois à les défier alors qu'on a un petit niveau pour être reconnu par les autres.
So don't look to bellow that ones that create the moves, that create the dance.
L'essentiel dans la danse, c'est de prendre de la maturité, de grandir avec ça dans l'esprit.
The most important thing is to get older, how do you call that? Wise, to get wise to that. To get wise and search.
Tu dis, je souhaite la paix à tous les gens qui sont ouverts.
He wish peace for all the people that open mind.
Peace!
Yeah. Check it out. If y'all want to get in touch with these brothers, y'all can do so. If y'all had any problems, let me know. And I'll get y'all to them. Alright? Right about now, my man, B-Boy, David, from the French Connection crew, representing for you. Check it out.
All right, all right. Say what's up, Mr. Wiggles. Breakaway Video Magazine. Chilling out here with my peoples. My brother, Fatih. Mm. What's up, kid?
Ça va?
Ça va bien.
Ça va bien.
So ask him. We got my brother right here. Twister's gonna translate. What's up, Twister? Yo, ask him, man, what's the name of his crew?
Okay, quel est le nom de ton groupe? Connection, Original Flavor, Jad. So Connection, Original Flavor, and Jad.
These are all people that he hangs out with and kicks it with, right? Or his friends?
Ce sont tous des gens de Jad ici. Il y a un mélange. Il y a Original Flavor, a mix with the Original Flavor, Jad. Jad.
Okay.
Connection.
Connection.
Original Flavor.
Okay.
Original Flavor.
Original Flavor.
Jad.
Coucou.
Alright.
So, just real quick, let us know, what are you trying to do out here, Fatih? So, with these B-boys? What is Fatih doing out here with all the heads out here?
Yeah, qu'est-ce que tu fais ici? Avant tout, je suis danseur. First of all, I'm a dancer.
All right.
Et j'essaie de de faire pas mal de choses pour les danseurs. To do many things for the dancers. Les réunir dans des soirées. To make reunion with the
Reunion, yeah, uniting all the dancers.
Uniting all the dancers. Dans des spectacles, dans des voyages, with the shows and the travels.
And what's the message you want to send to all the b-boys, b-girls, and the whole world?
Envoyer à tous les breakers, les b-boys et les b-girls dans le monde. Suivre les pionniers du mouvement.
Follow the pioneer of the moves.
Et être tous, c'est en
to be close to close.
United.
Être solidaire.
To be united.
Et non, bla 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 bla.
Yeah. Check it out.
French.
Get down. In my hotel lobby, in Paris, France.
France. Enough respect to the hip hop scene in France. They be representing out there. Yeah. That's my man, B-Boy Fati, representing France, all the B-Boys out there, right about now, B-Boy Frankie Flav.
All right. Over here with my man, Frankie, representing out here, doing promotion work for Sketches at the Shoe Show in Las Vegas in February, whatever today's day is, chilling here.
Mr. Wiggles,
you got the wiki man and Easy Rock, always working.
Look,
Selly.
That's my new name.
Diesel. Diesel. What's up, Frankie?
What's up, man?
What's your dance name again, bro?
Flav. They call me Flav.
What crew are you down with?
From LA Breakers.
LA?
Yeah, LA Breakers.
The Mexican.
Yes, the Mexican guy.
Mexican. How you feel, brother, dancing out here with all these people with Mind, Mr. Wiggles, Easy Rock, Wicked?
Very nice, man. It's very nice. You guys are really good people. Wiggles got some shit. Excuse me. Sorry for my language.
Dad.
How's it feel? Wiggles got some stuff. He's real nice. Wicked got some stuff. Easy Rock got some stuff. Remind got some stuff. You guys are all good. And, you know, when you're around some, you know, the good guys, you're also gonna be really not intimidated, but you're gonna be happy.
You're gonna get better.
Get better and stuff.
Hey, how's it feel getting paid doing what you love to do?
Very good. The money just comes and goes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about your B-boy history.
I've been dancing for 7 years. In 92 I started. I didn't have nobody to show me the B-boy concept, you know, nobody showed me the original stuff, the Latino dances, the Brooklyn rocks, and, you know.
So that's what's good about working is that now you get the opportunity to work and you get to learn all that, but you did a lot on your own, too. Who were some of your idols growing
My
up?
My idols was Mr. Wiggles. I gotta say that name, man. He got some stuff. The original Rockers.
Oh, okay.
The Renegades got some stuff.
Yep.
The Rocksteadies, Rocksteady crew. My idols were Kent Swift.
Oh, right.
Flowmaster.
Okay.
Remind got some stuff. I really like Remind's character.
Definitely.
He can dance. And the best battle I ever seen was the Rocksteady versus Style.
That was the best battle I ever seen.
Remind was showing some stuff, and Flo and Kenny, you were out there.
Yeah, a little bit.
Just handling your business. That's in the history books.
Tell me about your group.
LA Breakers, it's an original crew out there in LA. It's been around since the 80s. I'm down with Fresh and Freeze. And, it's really good. You know, I'm learning some stuff off you guys, and I'm learning some stuff off them. So I'm in the middle trying to learn both sides of LA and New York styles and LA styles. You know.
What's some of the accomplishments you want to get out of B-boying and hip-hop culture?
Just to have it in my heart, just to dance with my heart, and just to have fun.
Right.
You know, it's also good making some money on the side, but it's out of my heart I do it. I'm really into the hip-hop scene.
Right. Say something to the people, like all the B-boys and B-girls, hip-hop, and say something to all of the people.
Yo, stay up, everybody. Just do what you guys are doing. You're keeping it alive. You know, just do what you guys are doing. That's all I got to say.
Yo, you got something in your mouth, bro. Get that out of there. You got sick puppies.
Yeah. Give it up. B-boy Frankie Flav. Y'all want some products? Hit them up. Next up, the Skechers promo show at the Magic Shoe Convention 99. Next up, from the Electric Boogaloo, the amazing Poppin' Pete demonstration. Check it out. For the Poppin' Pete video. That needs to happen. Get the interview. Mad information. Mad Boogaloo style. Keep it out. Check it out. Y'all want to check out this video? Hit www.electricboogaloo.com. Get the Poppin' Beat video and other Electric Boogaloo products. Check it out. Next up to bat, y'all gonna bug out on them. The Box Turtles.
It's been a long time since I put pen to paper. Aerosol vapor got me high as a skyscraper. Guess I should wear my respirator. True blue boogers and Krylon-coated brain tissue. Monolithic memories, oh how I've missed you. Youthful days rocking freestyles for fun. Now my art pays. But anyways, purple haze of responsibilities. But still I'll freeze. Toy suckers, cold as ice. Mice, they fight for cheese and think that's what it's all about. I bought bout after bout at the graffiti championship. But I don't sip on that champagne shit. Rap I flip. But all these ignorant toys about the singing ego shit. They triple and stumble. Get on the microphone and just mumble. Talking that weak mumble jumbo. I kick your ass and then go off city like Sofa Dash and Dumbo. Then I hop on a freight train and drop bombs with my man Suge and some hobo. Oh no. So I got a little carried away like toxic shit in the ocean. 40 ounce potion got you drowning in a sea of pain. Oh, was that just the toilet? Oh shit. Lush, lyrical fat cap bum rush. You need to hush if your flavor has no nutrition. Maybe you should shut up and listen. Cause content you're missing. Your flow sound fucked up like a bum pissing on himself. You need some banaka for that cock of breath. For me, I'll rip the mic till ain't nothing left. Oh, well I guess I was still dreaming. Cause this ignorant bullshit will still have these kids screaming. When I wake up, real woolly boys replaced with plastic toys. Choreographed with bullshit videos where silicone hoes pose over recycled tracks with raps about dicks and gats. Getting used by the devil like hot coals at a barbecue. Hell nah, I ain't saying sorry to all these shit pop suckers trying to be hip hop lovers. Getting fucked under covers. Now your style has AIDS cause they didn't even use no rubbers. Think three times before you open your mouth. Self-degradation should have died with the self. What? You're making money? Funny. Your master's making 90 times more than you. And it's all about who and what? When you're gone, you're gone. The only thing that remains is your impression on the children's brain.
Yo, wasn't that phenomenal, y'all? That's some new next level shit.
Box Turtles, Prankster One, Mike 360, Omega.
How did they get Omega in touch with y'all to get y'all CD?
I got a discount. We're working on a Box Turtle thing at the same studio. Hopefully, you'll be working at. We're hoping to put together. Well, we're working on an all a cappella version of the Box Turtle stuff through Sound Scientific, and we're hoping that Mr. Wiggles, one of our great inspirations as an artist.
Oh.
We'll remix some of our work.
What?
And also perform with some of our stage
shows. What? Doing. After seeing that, that'd be my honor.
You can contact us at MIKE3, the number, SIXTY, at yahoo.com, or 505-969-6576. Peace. Organic Ghetto, Box Turtles.
Peace, Omega TAK, Box Turtle representing for life. My boy Mike, my boy On.
Alright.
Check out the back. Yo, we don't just rhyme, we rock the floor, we beatbox, all that shit. Paint,
freight train,
kung fu, capoeira, flamenco, anything.
Stay right there.
Yeah. Give it up for the Box Turtles, y'all. Y'all want some products? Just hit them up. Next up the bat, representing in the cypher out in Holland. The legendary Crazy Legs from the Rock Steady Crew. Check it out. Wow. y'all can hit up Crazy Legs at BoxSteadyCrew.com. Otherwise, peace. Breakaway 3.
There it is, y'all. Breakaway Video Magazine Part 3. Hope y'all like that video, man. I had a boy put it together. I know it took a minute, but I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I'm traveling too much. I try to get y'all the footage as soon as possible, but, you know, sometimes I get delayed with the traveling. But I want to shout out all the people that contributed to this video. People in Holland, Taiwan, the French people, the Tribal Jam, you know what I'm saying, the Hungry and Flying Steps. And, oh, my idol, Papa Pete, man. I get the video, the Papa Pete video's off the hook. You know what I'm saying? Teal Steel, that brother's off the hook. 360 and his people, the Box Turtles, man. They come up with some new immaculate stuff, you know what I'm saying? It's a little twist on hip-hop, you know? Frank Flay, that's my man, doing the Skechers thing. All the people that participated in the Skechers commercial and the Skechers promotion, you know what I'm saying? Who am I forgetting up in this piece? Crazy Legs, that's my brother, my Rock Steady brother, you know what I'm saying? I put him in there to show he ain't lose a step. The brother still got the skills and the flavor and the dance ability, you know what I'm saying? Be on the lookout for that. You know, man, Footwork Fanatics, come on now. Flow Master and Wicked, and we're still on the lookout for some new members. You know, Flow was trying to check out some more Footwork Fanatics out there. Everybody that represented us, the Grand Wizard Theodore, who's my idol, for him to say I'm his idol is retarded. I've been following him since I was a shorty. Yo, enough to be said, man. That brother's incredible, man. Everybody on this video represented, all the B-boys that represented in the Tribal Jam. And the Indian brothers get down doing the original Top Rock flavors, man. Yo, you can see where Brooklyn Rockin' and all that, you know, has its influence, man. The Indian brothers, man, and all the people of, you know, Native American people, man, y'all need to realize that the contributions y'all did for hip-hop is there. And the essence of hip-hop, man, is from what y'all people created with y'all culture, too. So don't ever forget that. Oh, man, hope I didn't forget nobody on this video. God bless everybody. I want to shout out all my sponsors, Tribal Gears. These are my people. Everybody supporting this gear is wearing fat-ass gear, you know, straight up and down. Skechers to spot me with the fat kicks. Workman's Outlet, Mr. Rags, Zaline Distribution. Everybody that buys and supports my videos, man, thank y'all. I really appreciate it. I'm doing it from the heart, man, and I know I'm making a little ends out of it, keeping me alive, keeping me afloat, but I'm trying to give y'all some quality stuff, man. I hope y'all enjoy my products. And, you know, love all of y'all people out there. Y'all want to get up on the video magazine, you know what I'm saying? Hit me up, man. Send me some footage, you know? I'm ready to put everybody up in this piece and give everybody a fair spotlight. This video is meant for everybody. And in exchange for y'all giving me the footage, because I do sell these videos, you know? In exchange, I offer y'all the opportunity to shine and the opportunity to put your number up to make contact with B-boys from all over the planet to sell y'all stuff through my video. And each volume that I have, I offer for any B-boy that participates in my video to have free commercial space. And so far, a lot of B-boys haven't taken advantage of this opportunity, but all the B-boys out there that took place in this video, took part in my videos, more than welcome. Get y'all commercials up in my video. Any volume is open to y'all brothers. That's my exchange, you know. Peace and love to all y'all people, brothers and sisters out there, B-boys and B-girls, poppers and lockers and all that hip-hop. Stay cool.
Yeah. Casa de Hiroki Design. Best value for your hip-hop design. They do logos, business cards, video covers, album covers, layout and design, creative concepts. These are the brothers that have been doing my covers. Covers from Style Elements and other people's as well. Y'all definitely want to get up with these brothers. They got it going on. Yeah, yeah. Check it out. Casa de Hiroki Design. Contact Daniel Martinez and get some fat. Design, computer graphics. Also, be on the lookout for the new up and coming video presented by Casa de Hiroki. Breaking Boundaries, the video. It was all that, I was there. Massive B-boy celebrity, B-boy battle, B-box show, and DJ Grand Wizard Theodore.